any fucking broken dreams. They're everywhere. I'm just gonna walk my dog. And he's like, give me. So I'm like walking the dog, everything's normal. This lady starts coming towards me, and I live in downtown, mind you. Okay, you know? And you can't tell someone's a whack job until they get close enough to see that fucking crazy look in her eye. She just looked tan, you know what I mean? So she gets closer and closer, and finally I'm like, oh shit. CougarFuneral.com. It's the Christian section. No, I know. And then I was like, all right, I'm going to go shopping. I decided I'm going to go out and go to a mall and go get something. So I'm like, okay, so I got these shoes, the meanest fucking store in Los Angeles. I try to walk into Forever 21. I get there. There's a 21-year-old bouncer chick wearing like leopard flats, smoking a vape like a fucking asshole. You know what I mean? She fucking stops me and looks me up and down. She goes, sorry, basement. And I was like, I'm like, what is in the basement? She's like, Forever 43. And I'm like, wow, okay, that's fucked up. You go from 21 to middle-aged in clothing, you know what I mean? Like, you know, what is this, the fucking Logan's Run of fucking clothing stores? Like, this is bullshit. I'm not going down there. YouTube, you know. She's like, no, seriously, like you look pretty. Like, you could almost be a model. Seriously, like, you could be a model. I'm like, oh my God, wait, Lisa, this is like the nicest you've ever been to. That is so sweet of you to say that. And that's so weird, because I was just talking to my agent, and I was like, you know, maybe I could do print work. She's like, oh God, not like a pretty model, you know. Like a model for like Weight Watchers, or like the Suicide Pistol. Younger guy, you know what I mean?
Woo!
No one cares. Pop love. I'm just kidding. No, I'm dating a younger guy. And it's so much better than dating older guys, because I always feel like older guys have like ear hair, you know? And cancer, you know? And I just feel like younger guys are just, they're just a little bit more laid back. They're less judgmental, less baggage. Like, they don't judge you by bringing homemade popcorn to the movies and like a glass of wine. You know what I mean? And like, they kind of err on the side of a little bit irresponsible, and I super appreciate that, because we had a baby. Uh-huh. Everyone believes me when I say that. I really did have a baby. In fact, we're having another one.
Woo!
You know what I mean? You know what I mean? I'm going to LA, you know what I mean? I just tried to look like Mia Farrow, you know, like Rosemary's Baby. have babies because I had no idea that when you have a baby, people are so nice to you. You know what I mean? It's so cool. Honestly, if I knew people were going to be this nice to me, I would have gotten knocked up when I was 12. You know? It's so amazing. You know? And I have a super cute, really super cute little girl. I mean, she's so cute. And the thing is, like, she's just adorable. Like, so... You know what? Let someone compliment. Do you know there's like cute babies out there, but then there's like not as cute babies out there, right? Right. And so you know when a mother compliments in your baby, it's expected that you return the compliment. That's kind of like motherhood. So this lady in the park was like, "Oh my God, what a little princess you have! What a little princess! Did you get a look at my little prince?" I look at that thing. I'm like, "Oh my fucking God! That's not a prince. That's a toad." You know? But you gotta think of a compliment off the cuff. And the only thing you think of was like, "Aww, is it a rescue?" Yeah, it didn't work out. Having a new friend is hard, you know. So I'm sort of proud of this. I know we're like in August, but I have one New Year's resolution that I've kept to, and I'm kind of proud of it. And that is that I promised myself I'd get rid of all my granny panties. Do you guys know what granny panties are? Do you guys have moms, right? Okay, so if you don't know what a granny panty is, they're underwear, okay, and they're about like this wide, about this long. They used to be white, but now they're like manila colored. Yeah, it's okay. It's from washing. And I always check my underwear drawer every month just to make sure I don't have any there. But there's like this one fucking pair. This one pair that always seems to make its way back into my drawer. It's really weird. You know what I mean? I'm like, it's almost like she has a, you know what I mean? It has its own, you know what I mean? Like, I was like, ew. And it's always like, I look in there, I'm like, ah, shit, it's still there. You know, it's like, Cammy, you need me. What are you gonna do that time of the month, man? What are you gonna rely on, this little G-string and a fucking boy short? Nah. Listen, Cammy, I may be fucking ugly. I may be old, but I got high. I don't know, I'm a big Rocky fan, so... I'm a big Rocky fan. But you know what? The granny panties do have a purpose. I do always keep one pair in my purse, just in case. Well, here's why. I don't like to sit on a toilet in a public restroom, right? You know what I mean? For obvious reasons, because there's man-eating bacteria in every toilet, you know what I mean? On this. So your option is to like take one of those white, you know, covers and like, you know, the only way that sticks is if it's glued by like urine that's already on the toilet, right? You're right there sitting in man-eating fucking STD piss, right? And so you're like, ah, okay, so then you try to do a mirror effect. You know what I mean? You're like, oh, put another one on, and I'll put that in, right? You put another one on. Made these, you know what I mean? All you can do is like pile it up until it's like a paper mache mountain. You know what I mean? You just kind of like lean against it, right? And piss like a man, you know? And then, okay, but usually they don't even have those things, right? So then you're forced to do the squat, you know? This is the squat. Now, I don't do that squat. I don't do the yoga squat, you know what I mean? I have to do the side squat because I grew up in the 80s. I saw so many horror movies, and I'm afraid a hand is going to come up. You know what I mean? So I got to have a sniper view, like, on the toilet to make sure, you know what I mean? It's dangerous. Now, the problem with the side angle is that 9 out of 10 times, the piss just starts rolling down your leg, you know what I mean? And it goes and it goes and rolling, rolling, and it's always, if no one else is in the bathroom, but then bam, always that bitch has to go in there right while the shh going through, and I'm like, oh no, this is gonna be so embarrassing. stayed in that. And, you know, I haven't been there in a while, and I forget how amped up and proud Bostonians tend to be. I mean, right, Chelsea. They just do. And so I went into, like, a Starbucks. Don't ask me why. I hate the coffee. But anyway, probably just using the bathroom, you know what I mean? And so I walk in there, and I hear this guy. So I hear a guy with a Boston accent, and some of the conversation being like, hey, man, I can hear your Boston accent. What part of Boston are you from? And he'd be like, I'm from Southie. It went more like this. It was like, hey, man, I can hear your Boston accent. He's like, you better fucking believe I got a fucking goddamn fucking Boston fucking accent. He's like, does my family earn this fucking Boston accent? Because we are the very first Rochelle of fucking hands from Ireland off the goddamn motherfucking Mayflower. Same amped up and proud attitude. No fucking joke. Like, I leave my house, Rocky is his name, I come back, he's like, ah, I'm fucking hungry! I'm a fucking purebred Boston fucking terrier! I can't believe you fucking leave me here, this fucking luck, I'm so under me, my hind legs! And I'm like, whoa, Rocky, you need to calm down. He's like, why'd you gotta get me up to some fucking boxer from fucking Philly? It's bullshit, okay? But you can be Mocky Mock, you know what I mean? Larry Bird, just a fucking funky bunch. I'm like, I'm sorry. He goes, and why are you telling all your fucking friends that I'm a fucking rescue dog? Do I look like a fucking rescue dog? Do you see these markings? Do you see this fucking jawline? That's the best in show action. I'm like the Sandy Crawford of the dogs, you see my mole. I'm so fucking purebred. My fucking mother is my fucking sister. That's why I'm a lady. I'm a fucking...